Hello, this will be a supplementary video for part 9 of our Metroidvania series, where I'll be bringing you through updates like bug fixes and code optimizations. Let's start off with multiple audio clips being played during our jump. The cause for this is due to our jump method being called in update. Thus, the method is rapidly called and plays the audio clip repeatedly as long as the if condition for the jump is satisfied. Therefore, we just need to move the code to play the audio clip into another if statement, but this time, we'll check for when the jump button is pressed down. This should make it such that the audio clip will only play once, which is during the first time we press the jump button. Next, another issue with sound is for the casting audio being played despite not having casting abilities unlocked. The reason for this is due to our audio clip being called outside of the ability unlock conditions in the cast coroutine method. Copy the code that plays the spellcast sound and paste it into each of your individual cast if statements containing the condition for whether they are unlocked. Another improvement we'd like to make is to save the game when exiting to the main menu. This would be a simple improvement where all we'll have to do is create a public save game method in the game manager script that calls save data instance save player data. Then we'll hit the quit to main menu button in the canvas prefab, where we can add the save game method to the on click function of the button in the inspector. Make sure to place this method at the top of the order, as the on click function will run the processes down in order. With that, we should be able to quit the game in the main menu and have our game properly saved for the next time we continue the game. Finally, some people have issues with the pause menu not appearing when pausing the game. So for this, we'll check one thing and change another. First, check that your pause menu and its children are set active in the canvas prefab. We need it active since our method of turning the pause menu on and off is not setting it active and inactive, but rather changing its alpha value to appear invisible and visible. Next, we'll make a minor change to the fade UI script. Like with anything for stopping the time scale, we'll change the time.deltaTime to time.unscaledDeltaTime in the fade out and fade in coroutines. This prevents the UI from freezing before it can change the alpha of the pause menu. And that's all for part 9. I hope this video has solved your issues and improved your mechanics for part 9 of the Metroidvania series. There will be a link in the description regarding these changes made to part 9 of the series that will cover all of the fixes discussed in this video. If you have a problem or question that has not yet been covered, or is a unique circumstance, do head to our community forums at blogterrorsquad.com in the description for assistance. Thanks for watching, and hope you enjoyed the video.